So the weird thing is we don't exist in the physical world. We do exist inside of a story that the brain tells itself. Basically, a brain cannot feel anything. A neuron cannot feel anything. They're physical things. Physical systems are unable to experience anything. But it would be very useful for the brain or for the organism to know what it would be like to be a person and to feel something. Imagine you look at the Mandelbrot fractal, right? This famous thing that Bernard Mandelbrot discovered.
Mandelbrot, yeah.
If you you see an overall shape in there, right? But you know, that if you truly understand it, you know it's two lines of code. It's basically in a series that is being tested for complex numbers in the complex number plane for every point. And for those where the series is diverging, you paint this black.
Yes.
And where it's converging, you don't. And you get the intermediate colors by checking how far it diverges.
Yes.
Right. This is, gives you this shape of this fractal. But imagine you live inside of this fractal and you don't have access to where you are in the fractal, or you have not discovered the generator function even. Right. So what you see is all I can see right now is a spiral, and the spiral moves a little bit to the right. Is this an accurate model of reality? Yes, it is. Right. It is an adequate description. You know that there is actually no spiral in the Mandelbrot fractal. It only appears to, like this, to an observer that is interpreting things as a two-dimensional space and then defines certain regularities in there at a certain scale that it currently observes, because if you zoom in, the spiral might disappear, turn out to be something different at a different resolution, right?
Yes.
So at this level, you have the spiral, and then you discover the spiral moves to the right and at some point it disappears. So you have a singularity. At this point, your model is no longer valid. You cannot predict what happens beyond the singularity. But you can observe again, and you will see it hit another spiral, and at this point it disappeared. So maybe you now have a second order law. And if you make 30 layers of these laws, then you have a description of the world that is similar to the one that we come up with when we describe the reality around us.
So above and beyond, I am man.
Said on this topic, you said in a recent conversation that, quote, some people think that a simulation can't be conscious and only a physical system can, but they got it completely backward. A physical system cannot be conscious. Only a simulation can be conscious.
Yeah.
Consciousness is a simulated property of the simulated self.